shaggy, dark brown, browny grey colour with scaly, feathery wigs.
Another case of the root weevils. The woman rang me crying through the fog. Now you could hear the root weevils scratching at the rafters to get in under the slates. Bloody, I don't know where they came. For years in Ireland, terrible problem for roots. People have pests with them. The dudes get in under the slates to keep you awake. This woman. Oh, the sun isn't happy about the root weevils. Over the years I've got used, I'm still not happy about them. I don't know, there's all kinds of stories that they can get into your body and attack you and all. The damage they do to the roots is unreal. They can eat through a slate, asbestos slates, the modern asbestos slates, they're not so keen on the old banger slates of which this roof, this lady's roof is made of. You can eat through those in a couple of seconds and get in. But damn things, if they get into the house, they make an awful mess. They go through the slates, but you can imagine, them getting into flowers and timber and pasta or, my God, you've had to pull the house. Then the roof even must have got this lady here. They're taking legs off people. She probably only lost. You ready, son? We're just going to swing around to the left here. It's always exciting. Keep an eye out for them. Slate's gone, but look at the worst damage. You see this? Look. That was all here. They got in here, the bastards, this whole fucking stack would come down. Where's that chopper? We have to call them back. You get this hammer near them, they're dead. The only weevil is a dead weevil, as far as I'm concerned. To do this damage here. This is only recently done. There was probably even a queen weevil. Queen weevil could have done this damage. And then around here, this is a tin of anti-weevil paste, very expensive, but it's good. You paste it on in different sections of the roof where they've damaged it, because they come back to the damaged areas again, and if they eat it, it can kill them. But they can die in flight, and people have been known to be knocked out and broken arms and things from the fall from the sky, weevils falling. This here. You would think it was ordinary sand and cement or mortar, but it's not. There's anti-weevil agent in it. That will hopefully keep them from attacking at least this section. A woman just shouted to me from the street that she thinks there's a weevil attacking number 7. That's not too far across. We get tidied up here, head over there, try and get them buggers out of that one. So they go from one roof to another. And they hay on this roof and they're hammering
to go somewhere else in the locality. Don't travel too far. It's over to number 7 now in a few minutes. Sometimes you're walking late on a roof. You're walking, say, trying to finish off a roof, taking the winter time, and it gets dark 4 or 5 o'clock. You'd hear the bugger swooping down, the noise of them, and you'd be lucky to get away because they'd eat the roof ladder. Not so bad. Believe it or not, I'd have to get up the leg of your trousers. That's it. Weave it like this. About this length, like a large maggot. Dark brown, browny grey colour with scaly, leathery wings. A grey flying maggot. Roof weave. Roof weave. Now we're on the roof of number 7. Come over to this roof out on the upper one. Come over to number 7 to see where these damn things are in on this roof. You can see they've already started to cut loose in the slate, so hopefully there isn't too much damage here. We always have the hammer at the ready to kill them. Just a minute ago, a black cat over on the carpet over here. And that's a sign that a young weaver around because the cats feed off the young to catch them. A delicacy for cats, young weaver. A man over in the house over here has a weed growing out of a chimney stack. Wanted me to remove it. And I told him, I'm a vermin hunter, vermin repair hunter. Gotta be a botanic expert. Oh, I wouldn't want to get someone else. This here is proof that the roof weasel was located in this area. This is some of his droppings. And this here is an injector that you inject into the droppings in case there's any eggs which will breed and bred more trouble. So we just inject them now. That'll kill them. That's two reels completed in the space of a few hours. Roof damage. But who knows, tonight they will return. May not be in my area, but they will return. Someone will get a call. I'm back.